स्टूडेंट टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस चैप्टर 12 एक्सपोनेंट्स एंड पावर्स ओके सो लेट्स सी व्हाट इज दिस दिस इज 10 अबव 24 सो 10 इज कॉल्ड बेस एंड 24 इज कॉल्ड एक्सपोनेंट्स ओके 10 is called base, this is 10, above 24 we write, so 10 is called base and 24 is called exponents, okay, so we can read it 10 raised to the power 24, what we read it 10 raised to the power 24, again we want to say 10 is called base, and 24 is called its exponents we say 10 raised to the power 24 this is clear now some important law of exponents we are going to discuss here okay so what is the some exponent important exponents let's see so here you know what is base and what is power So first law is that if base are same in the case of multiplication, then their power will added. Okay. So let's see. If a to the power m into a to the power n, here you can see base are equal same a, but power are different. If in this case if base are equal and base are equal and case of multiplication then their power will added okay so here you can write a to the power m plus n this is only two terms a to the power m a to the power n we can write it so many terms like if you have a to the power m into a to the power n into a to the power r into a to the power p so you can write it a to the power m plus n plus r plus p this is clear so you can see here base of each are equal a and power is different and so we can add their power we repeat base a exponent m plus n plus r plus p this is clear now in general you can say if you have a to the power m into m1 into a to the power m2 into a to the power m3 into a to the power m4 into dot. So this will be equal it is equal to a to the power m1 plus m2 plus m3 plus m4 plus and so on this is clear this is the first law of exponent and second is that and we take some example related to this law of exponent clear so here in your syllabus only the two numbers a to the power m into a to the power n this is equal to a to the power m plus n this is clear now we take some example related to this law suppose you have 2 to the power 3 into 2 to the power 4 okay so if you solve it here you can see base is 2 but power is different so in this case when you know very well when the base are same and it is the case of multiplication then their power will be added so you can write it 2 to the power 3 into 2 to the power 4, this is equal to 2 to the power 3 plus 4, this is equal to 2 to the power 7. Okay. So I hope all of you understood this law of exponent. This is the first law of exponent. And you can take another example. If you have 3 power 4 into 3 power 8 into 3 power 9. So this is equal to, here you can see the base is 3 of it. This is each term, this is equal. And so you can write it 3 to the power 4 plus 8 plus 9. Okay, this is equal to what? 3 to the power 4 plus 8, 12, 12 plus 9, 21. So you can read it. 3 rise to the power 21. This is clear. So I hope all of you understood this paper and this law of exponent, a to the power m into a to the power n. This is equal to a to the power n plus m plus n. Now the next law of exponent is, if this is the case of multiplication, if base are same, a to the power m divided by a to the power n. Okay, you can see here this is a case of multiplication and base are same, power is different. So you can write here a to the power m minus n. Clear? A to the power m minus n. Suppose you have 2 to the power 8 divided by 2 to the power 3. So you can solve it. 2 to the power 8 minus 3. This is equal to what? This is equal to nothing but 2 to the power 5. If we subtract 3 from 8, then we obtain 5. This is clear? Now, this is like this form. If you have 3 to the power 10 divided by, this is divided by 3 to the power 4. You can also write this like this, 3 to the power 10 divided by 3 to the power 4. This is equal to, here you can see base are equal, and the case of division, then we subtract their power. Okay, so you can write here 3 to the power 10 minus 4. This is equal to what? Nothing but 3 to the power 6. Here you can read it. 3 raised to the power 6. Okay. So this is a second law of exponent in the power. Okay. Now, third law. Third law exponent is that a to the power n, if a to the power n whole power n, a to the power m whole power n, this is equal to a to the power m into n. Clear? So for example, if you take 5 to the power 4 whole power 2, so this is equal to what? Power to the power. So it means that multiply of their power. So you can write here 5 to the power 4 into 2. And this is equal to nothing but 5 power 8. 5 raised to the power 8. Clear? Now, is this clear? Now next properties, next law of exponents. If you have 2 numbers a into b, this is a into b, okay, power m You can write this a into b power m. This is equal to nothing but a to the power m into b to the power m. Is this clear? Or you can write it if two numbers have like this, a to the power m into b to the power m. Clear? Here you can see base are different but power is same. Base are different but power is same. So you can write again it like this, a into b, this is equal to power m. Okay, a to the power m is equal to a to the power m into b to the power m, this is equal to a into b whole power m. For example, you can see here 6, you can take 6, 6 power 4. So you can write 6 is equal to what? 6 is equal to 2 into 3. You can write 6 is equal to 2 into 3. So here also we can write 2 into 3, sorry, 2 into 3 whole power 4, because here 6 to the power 4. So you can write here 4. It means that you can write it according to this law, a to the power a b to power m is equal to a power m into b power m. So here you can write 2 to the power 4 into 3 to the power 4. This is clear. And now suppose you have 2 to the power 5 into, we take another example, okay, 2 to the power 5 into 5 to the power 4. Okay, so here you can see, 5 to the power 5, 5 to the power 5, we take another example, 2 to the power 5 into 5 to the power 5. So in this case you can see base are different, base are different but power is same. When base are different and power is same, then we use this this law of exponent, a to the power m into b to the power m, this is equal to a into b whole power m together. So here you can see a b are not equal. Here you can see a then not is equal to b. Clear? And here you can also see 2 then not is equal to 5. Okay, so this case we will apply it here. It means that it becomes 2 into 5 to the power nothing but 5, or you can say 2 5 10. So this is equal to 10 to the power 5, 10 raised to the power 5. This is clear. So student, this is a law of exponent powers, and we have also a lot of law related to the exponents. Next law of exponent is, suppose we have in the form of rational number a to the power a by b to the power m. So you can write it a to the power m by b to the power m. This is clear. Okay, now suppose you have 2 by 3 power 6. So you can write it 2 power 6 by 3 power 6. This is clear. Now next, a by b whole power m, this is equal to, you can write a power m by b power m, a to the power m by b to the power m. For example, 2 by 3 whole power 6, you can write 2 to the power 6 by 3 to the power 6. Now if any numbers have power ending in a form like this, a by b, its power is negative. minus m. So how you can write it positive power in powers, positive in exponents. So you can write just opposite. You can write thus, write its reciprocal, then it become positive. Okay, so you can write here, this is a by b, you can write here b by a. So here the power is becomes positive. Okay, suppose you have 2 by 5 to the power minus 4. Okay, so we need to write it in positive powers. So for this we write it as reciprocal, means you can write here 5 by 2 to the power plus 4, or simply you can write 5 by 2 whole power plus 4. This is clear. Now if any number have power minus m, minus 1, so 8 power minus 1, it means that this is equal to 1 upon 8. If you have 8 to the power minus 2, then you can write it 1 upon 8 to the power plus 2. Clear? If you have 8 to the power minus 3, suppose, then this is equal to, you can write it 1 upon 8 to the power 3. Similarly, you can write here a to the power minus m, so you can write 1 by a to the power plus m, a to the power m. Take 1 upon a to the power m. In this way you can write your power in positive exponent. This is the power in negative exponent, you can change it in positive exponent. This is clear. Now we have some other law of exponents. Suppose you have any number which power is 0. Any numbers like this 100, power is 0. Okay, 100 power is 0, its value is 1. In number 99, power is 0, so its value is 1. A to the power 4, A to the power 0, its value is always 1. 2 to the power 0, this value is always 1. 20 power 0, it becomes 1. Clear? So here you can see, if any numbers have power 0, its value is 1. Okay, now yeah. If you have multiplication in the form of 1 and the minus 1, like this, 1 to the power 99, its value is 1. Okay, 1 to the power 22, this is always 1. Okay, if you suppose you have 1 to the power 2, it means that 1 into 1, this is equal to 1. 1 power 4, this is equal to 1 into 1 into 1 into 1, this is equal to 1. Okay, now if you have minus 1, suppose you have minus 1, minus 1 to the power 2, it means that minus 1 into minus 1, so this is called minus into minus, this is equal to plus. 1 into 1, this is equal to 1. Okay, minus 1 into minus 1, minus into minus, this is equal to plus. Okay, and 1 into 1, this is equal to 1. Now if you have 1 power minus 1 power 3, so this is equal to what? 1 power 3 means we multiply minus 1 itself 3 times. So you can write here minus 1 into minus 1 into minus 1. So here in the first two terms, minus 1 into minus 1, this minus into minus, this is equal to plus. But again plus into minus, this is equal to minus. So So 1 into 1, 1, again 1 into 1, 1. So these are minus into minus. This is equal to plus, and plus into minus, this is equal to minus. So this is equal, you can write here, this is a, become minus 1. Now, if 1 to the power 4, if you have minus 1 to the power 4, then what you can see here? You can write minus 1, you can multiply minus 1 4 times itself. So you can write minus 1 into minus 1 into minus 1 into minus 1. This is equal to what? So you can see minus into minus. This is equal to plus. Minus into minus, this is equal to plus. Okay, and here minus into minus, again this is equal to plus. Plus into plus, this is equal to plus. So here we have done plus 1. As simple you can write here 1. Suppose we have minus 1 to the power 5. It means that here you can write minus, you can write, you can multiply minus 1 5 times itself. So you can write here minus 1 into minus 1 into minus 1 into minus 1 into minus 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is equal to what? Here you can see minus into minus, plus, plus into minus, minus, minus into minus, plus, plus into minus, it will become minus. So here you can write minus 1. And suppose if you have minus 1 to the power 1, it means minus 1. Okay? So here you can see if the power of minus 1 is odd number, so it becomes minus. Here 1, 3, 5. If power of minus 1 is odd number, so this result gives 5, minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, minus 1. If power of minus 1 is in even numbers, so it gives positive 1, plus 1, minus 2, minus 1, power 2, it gives 1, minus 4, minus 1 to the power 4, this is even number, this gives 1. So above discussion you can see here, if the negative powers have positive, have even numbers, then it's become, it's a result is positive. If the negative powers have odd number, then it's a result is negative numbers. Okay, this is clear. So for this decision you can see, you can say here if minus 1 power 21, so result will be what? So first we check the power is odd or even. Here you can see 21 is a odd number, so it means that this gives minus 1. Okay, and minus 1 to the power 13, this is equal to what? Minus 1 to the power 13. So value, if you multiply 1 how many times, your result will be 1, but here minus 1. So for this we check it's a power. If power is in even number, its result will be plus 1. If power is in odd numbers, its result will be minus 1. So here this is even number, it means that our answer is nothing but 1. Clear? Suppose we take another example, 1 power minus 99. So what is the answer? You can write here. This is two types. You can find the solution of this questions. First type is that you can multiply minus 1 in 99 times, and after this we find the result. Second time, according to the law of exponents, you can check its power. If power is odd number, then result will be positive. If power is even number, if power is even number, then result will be positive. And if power is odd numbers, then solution is negative. Here, so you can see minus 1 to the power 99. So here 99 is an odd number, this is not even number. How can you find this is odd number or even number? You know very well, if a number divisible by 2, then this number, then the number is even. If it is not divisible by 2, then you can say it is a odd numbers. Clear? So here 99 is odd numbers. So result of this, or you can write 1 power minus 1 power 99. This is equal to minus 1. Okay? If minus 1 to the power 100, here what is the answer? So if here you can see 100 is the even number, so this is equal to 1. Clear? Still that, I hope all understood this power with negative exponents. Now we are going to discuss some other example related to law of exponents. Now we are going to discuss multiplicative inverse of the numbers. Suppose we have a number 8 to the power m. We need to find its multiplication. So you write here multiplicative inverse of 8 to the power m. This is equal to 8 to the power minus m. Clear? Multiplicative inverse of 8 to the power m. This is equal to 8 to the power minus 1. Okay, also minus 1 you can write it 1 upon 8 to the power m. Okay, suppose you need to find the multiplicative inverse of a by b to the power t. Okay, so don't write the multiple like this, b by a to the power t. Okay, this is wrong. Or don't like this, a by b to the power minus t, according to this law. That here you write the multiplicative inverse of a to the power m, this is equal to 8 to the power minus m. This is a multiplicative inverse. Okay. So if you need to find the multiplication inverse of a to the power a by b to the power t whole to the power t, so you write it in proper manner like this, multiplicative inverse of a by b whole power t, this is equal to a by b whole power minus t. Or simply you can write it b by a to the power t. Clear? Now if you take some example related to the multiplicative inverse, if you take a number 2 to the power 3, what is the multiplicative inverse of 2 to the power 3? Then you can write it 2 to the power minus 3, or you can write it 1 by 2 power 3. Okay, if the number is given in rational numbers like this, 2 by 3 power 2. So what the multiplicative inverse? You write multiplicative inverse of 2 by 3. This is equal to 3 by 2 whole power 2. Here you write it's a reciprocal. Clear? 2 by 3 or 3 by 2. Now, so I hope all of you understood such types of question. Find the multiplicative inverse of the following numbers. Okay. Now we have some other questions related to the law of exponents. So let's see. Suppose we have 3 power minus 4. You need to evaluate it. So what can you do? First you write it's a positive form, it's a positive exponents, so you can write 3 power 4. Okay, because you know according to the law of exponent, if a to the power minus m, so you can write it 1 upon a to the power m. So according to this law of exponent, we can write 3 power minus 4, this is equal to 1 upon 3 power minus 4. Okay, so you can also write it 1 by 3 power 4, you can write it 1 by 3 into 3 into 3, how many times? 4 times. So if you multiply it, then we have 10, 3 into 3 is 9, 9 is 27, 27 is 81. So you can see here, 3 power minus 4, this is equal to 1 upon 81. So student, I hope all of you understood the law of exponents, and this is enough for today, and thank you for watching. Jai Hind.